bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Child of God, whatever man or woman sows, that they will reap. For 2 Corinthians 5:10 says, we must all appear before God, before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may be recompensed for his deeds in the body, according to what they had done, whether good or bad. And I'm sure you wondered if you had done more good than bad. Let me share with you, ignorance of what you are sowing won't stop you from reaping. Just like in a courtroom, you tell the judge, no, I didn't know that there was a law, but ignorance is not an excuse. You say, Your Honor, I didn't know doing 65 in the speed zone was against the law. You're still guilty. I read somewhere that it said, your present reveals much about your past. Take a child in a mall, they don't get their way, they start cutting up. They had no home training. They don't get what they want, they kick and scream and carrying on. You grow up on your own job, you don't get the promotion, you get overlooked. You don't get that raise, you acting a fool. Yeah. I ain't coming to work tomorrow. No home training. Now you don't get married, and when you're not getting your way, what happens? You may get cut off. You may get the solid treatment. Deacon Walker, don't want to get cut off. So most of the time, they're getting their way. You want to see an action movie, they want to see a comedy, a romance movie. Let them have their way. You don't want to get cut off. There's a seed time and there's a harvest time. So child of God, if you sow good seeds, you will reap good things. If you sow honesty, you will reap trust. If you sow goodness, you will reap friends. If you sow humility, you will reap greatness. If you sow perseverance, you will reap victory. If you sow hard work, you will reap success. If you sow forgiveness, you will reap reconciliation. If you sow to the Spirit, you will reap life everlasting. Amen. And that speaks of eternity.
Yeah.
And may I remind you, eternal life does not begin after you die. It begins at salvation. A child of God, on the other hand, if you sow bad seed, you will reap bad things. If you sow dishonesty, you will reap distrust. If you sow selfishness, you will reap loneliness. If you sow pride, you will reap destruction. If you sow jealousy, you will reap trouble. If you sow bitterness, you will reap isolation. If you sow worries, you will reap wrinkles. If you sow sin, you will reap guilt. If you sow to the flesh, you will reap corruption. And that speaks of decay, ruin, and destruction. Let your testimony be that of William Murphy. I have a seed in the ground.
Yeah.
I have this is my season for greatness.
Yeah.
This is my season to reap what I have sown. He's leaning in your direction.
Right.
He's leaning into your direction. Yeah. The favor is on you. You have a seed in the ground.
Right.
It has been said, a thought reap an act reap a habit reap character. So a character reap a destiny. So child of God, it is imperative that we sow the right kind of seeds, and it is equally imperative that we sow on the good ground. For that reminds me of Jesus telling a parable over in Matthew chapter 13, verse 3, if you follow me. And behold, a sower went forth to sow. Behold, a sower went forth to sow. And when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the fowls came and devoured them up. Some fell upon stony places where they had not much earth, and forthwith they sprung up because they had no depthness of earth. And when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprung up and choked them. But other fell on good ground and brought forth fruit, some 100-fold, some 60-fold, and some 30-fold. So child of God, you see how important it is for your seed to fall on good ground.
Yeah.
Don't let your seed fall by the wayside, for the fowls will eat them up. Don't let your seed fall in stony places, for when they sprout, the sun will scorch them. And please don't let your seeds fall by the thorns, or they be choked up by the cares of the life.
Amen.
Bishop T.T. Jakes said, you can change what you reap by changing what you sow.
Amen.
So it is the sowing and not the reaping that determines your harvest. So that comes to my close. Let me encourage you, child of God. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't give out. And don't give in.
Amen.
For every day is an opportunity for us to sow seeds.
All right. Amen.
But the question is, what's that song? The question is? The question is, what kind of seeds are you sowing? Are they seeds of the flesh, which are in Galatians chapter 5, 19 to 20? I'm just going to read some of them. Idolatry, witchcraft, wrath, strife, Brother Jimmy, envy, and so on. Or are they seeds of the Spirit, which is also found in Galatians 5, 22 and 23? Love, joy, Reverend Fricks, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, Reverend Walker, faith. So remember, you will reap what you sow. Thank you for listening. Amen. All right, Miss Reverend Holland, would you like to come and dismiss us, please?
Let us stand. Father, we thank you for your word this day. We are going to be mindful of sowing and reaping in the seeds that we sow, because we know we shall reap. So as we go down from this place, we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.